Hi guys, and welcome to another video of How to F3B. In this video I want to show you a nice trick how you can check different setups of ballast in your plane without having to disassemble and reassemble it every time. To use the trick you will need a CG scale, preferably one that's digital, your ballast and your glider, and some tape. So let's jump in and I will show you what I mean. As I already showed you in the last video, the pockets for the ballast are positioned in front of the wing joiner and in the back of the wing joiner. The pockets on this glider are 300 millimeters long and 250 millimeters long, so a bit shorter in the front. And if I do now want to place, like, for example, three pieces of brass in the chamber, I first have to insert some spacers, because otherwise the ballast would clunk around in the flight. These spacers are 3D printed. You can also make them out of wood or anything else. The only important thing is that they have a bit of space so they can wobble around a bit. That makes it much easier to get them out of the wing. So for this example, we want to put three pieces of brass into the wing. So at first I have to place three spacers in the wing, and then the three brass pieces are inserted. And for example, I want to put two pieces of brass in the front, so I put insert three of the small spacers in the front and two brass pieces. Yeah, and so now the wing is full and I could attach it to the fuse and ballast the other wing exactly the same way, and then put the wings, put the plane together and put it onto the CG scale. I will show you that in a minute. But if you now want to change your setup, you will have to disassemble the wing every time, put the ballast out, put the next ballast combination in, and then reassemble the model and then put it on the CG scale again. And I found a trick that will make this much easier, and I will show it to you. So what we want to do now is mark the position of the pockets over the wing, so we can put the ballast on the wing instead of into the wing. That will make it much easier and faster to try the different combinations of ballasting. What you need for that is something that is parallel. You can use this, which is a Zollstock in German, and put it into the pocket, into the ballast pocket, maybe the bigger one in your wing, insert it, and this will show you the way your ballast pocket goes through the wing. This is maybe not the most precise one, so maybe you find something else in your hobby room. I just found this profile of aluminium, which I can insert into the pocket. And I will use this flat profile of carbon fiber and put it right onto the wing. Okay, I will not use it, it's not really very straight. Yeah, so this one should make it. Yeah, so I built something special now out of profiles that were lying around here. There's a tube or a profile at the bottom and another one on top. And I make them parallel, and then I insert the bottom one into the wing pocket and the other one will lay on your wing. Be a bit careful so you won't make scratches into your wing. So this is the exact position. And now I will put some tape onto the wing at this position. So now this one is the exact edge of the ballast pocket in the wing. From here I can now measure back 30 millimeters, and from here I can now measure 30 millimeters to the back, and there's the so now I have the border of the pocket marked on the wing, and from here I can measure now the distance to the front pocket and put tape there too. Yeah, 47 millimeters. I will use some tape to make it possible to make marks. So somewhere over here. So now it's 47 millimeters from the back, which is about here. The same measure here. And now I can put on another tape. In this case, I will put it in front of the border so the wing is protected against the ballast pieces. And I will put another layer in the back so this area is also protected from the ballast pieces. So, same thing to the other wing. Yeah, so done with this. Now I will assemble the glider and then put it on the CG scale. So now the glider is assembled. I switched on the CG scale to get it to zero. And now I will put on the glider, respecting the space of my workshop. Make sure it's not touching anywhere. So now we can measure the CG and also the weight of the model. So now the model is set on the CG scale, and we can now start to put on the first combination of ballast. Always keep in mind that you have to fill the chamber, the pocket with spacers, and there's a total of 6 pieces. If your pieces are as big as mine, always make sure that you fill up the whole pocket. Yeah, so this is the first setup combination I tried. 6 pieces of brass in the back, 4 pieces of brass in the front. And now I would mark down the CG of the model and also the total weight, which is written on the display of the CG scale. Yeah, so now you can easily modify the setup. Maybe you want to take out some brass and put one more spacer in. It's very easy in the back and in the front also. Just make sure to line up with your marks on the wing. And yeah, it's much safer than disassembling and reassembling the glider several times in your workshop, with hitting the shelves and the workbench and something. Another tip is to make this inside, not outside, because wind will definitely disturb your measurements. Yeah, so have fun with this trick and see you at the next contest.